Happy Friday and welcome back to the Creative Classroom. I'm Kim Kesty here at Spellbinders. And we thought for this week's Try Friday, it might be fun, since we're getting a little closer to the holidays, to just share some kind of fun last minute cards, gifts, tags, things that you could do real quick. Maybe you're on your way to a party, just whatever the occasion may be. So thank you for watching. Whether you're watching on Facebook or YouTube, be sure to like and subscribe our videos. That always helps us out a lot. So let's take a look at some of the fun things we're going to be doing today. So first thing I want to share is this fun little stamp set. And it's just small, but a powerhouse. Now, a lot of our stamp sets are 4x6. This happens to be a 4x4. So it's just a real sweet, inexpensive little stamp set. And I really kind of fell in love with this sentiment that says, "All hearts come home for Christmas." So I said, you know what? Let's grab a bunch of my scraps of paper. And I went ahead and got my Misty out and stamped three different colors of cardstock with the sentiment. And then I just added some white powder and heat embossed it. So I kind of prepped that a little bit ahead of time for today's video, since we don't have to sit and listen to the sound of the heat gun. But once you've got this, and like you can see, I just grabbed this out of my stack pile. It just happened to be a piece I had there. And then I went to look for one of our tag sets. And I don't think I've ever showed off this tag set. It's just a super simple one. It's called Heart to Heart tag set, and you can see the item number. We'll put it in the description too. I don't even have it in packaging. I've used it quite a bit, but we developed this darling little set, and it's got all these fun little extra pieces, little scallops. This has a word that says thanks. This is the little tag topper that goes, you know, on top of the tag. I'll show you that in just a second. Just fold that little guy in half and it becomes, you know, a little reinforcer. Some extra strips for sentiments, a big row of hearts, and then one big heart that's so adorable, die cut. So I just kind of want to share, first of all, this tag set, because when I'm thinking of last minute Christmas gifts, it's all about the tags. It's like, quick, grab a tag, pop it on my package, I'm ready to go. I'm not going to use too many of the little extra pieces, but this tag is such a great size. It's like the perfect, you know, just mid-size tag. Not too big, not too small. So I'm going to go ahead and just use some of my best ever craft tape, by the way. I kind of tossed that to the side fast. But I do like to stamp before I die cut, especially if I'm just doing scraps, because I'm not always guaranteed that my stamping's straight or whatnot. So I always stamp first, and then I can just line up my die and make my last minute adjustments. You know, make sure it's everything's nice and straight on there. And that's why I use the best ever craft tape. And then I am going to bring in this little beauty, which I've only used once before in a video. This is our limited edition die cutting machine, so hopefully you can see how pretty it is. Actually, I'm going to close the front just so you can see the front of it now that we have this view. Look how pretty! Oh, it's got all the pretty flowers on the front. It's this beautiful teal, and we just love it so much. By the way, great gift for any crafter in your life. So it's all got the same, you know, insides as our normal Platinum 6. It's got all the power that you would expect. It does have these beautiful glitter plates, which, of course, I love. Sometimes it's sad to cut into them, but, you know, it's got to be done in the name of crafting, right? So I'm just going to quickly cut out this tag. All right. I might use this again. I'm not sure if I'm going to use it again on today's video, but. Okay, so you pop that out, and again, super cute, darling tag size. I could put the little reinforcer, and then you would just line up the holes like that and, you know, add a little bit of glue. It just makes it just a little extra special. But because I'm doing quick and easy today, I'm just leaving it as is. I'm just going to come in and bring a little length of ribbon. Now, there's a bunch of the satin ribbon on sale right now on the website, so if you guys go check it out. I actually feel a little bit bad because I think this candy apple is sold out, but I'm going to show you a couple more colors in a second that will work beautifully for the holidays too. But check out all the satin ribbon. It's a great width for all of your decorating and gift wrapping. So I'm just going to tie a little bow here. And I'm just doing kind of a monochromatic look. I did a couple more tags I'm going to show you in a minute. And I thought the red with the red satin ribbon with the red tag just kind of gives a little uniformity to it. Cut the ends, a little angle. We love our pro shears. They cut everything so beautifully. And honestly, that is all I'm going to do for this tag. Like, again, super simple. You could add a couple sparklies or a gem or any other embellishments. But I thought they were so sweet when I went ahead and cut them out of a variety of cardstock colors. Here we have our rainforest cardstock. And here we have our cosmic sky. So you can see that even if you were kind of into maybe making a little gift pack of tags, this would be super adorable too. Just grab your ribbon. Maybe you already have ribbon in your stash. And so just grab the cardstock that matches. And then all of a sudden you've got this super fun, coordinated little gift tag set. But I'm going to take one of them and add them to a little giftie that I did super quick. I think I'll do the green. So I just grabbed a little mason jar. And again, this would be adorable filled with treats. I know you guys have these sitting around. Handmade treats that you could eat. This happens to be a couple little mini ornaments. I thought this would be fun, you know, to decorate a small little tree or whatnot. And then to add the tag to the jar, I'm just going to grab some baker's twine. Or you could use jute or anything like that. And if I tie it around, I can just pop it right through this hole that I also tied the ribbon, you know, kind of double up here. Pop it around the jar. Got to even it out a little bit. And tie another bow right underneath this green bow. And then it gives a cute little double bow effect. I didn't get that quite even, but you guys kind of see the idea. Just dress it up, and all of a sudden, if you just have little sparklies in the jar, or again, candies, caramels, popcorn, any kind of homemade treat that you do, super adorable, super fun. All right, we'll set those aside. So I want to show one other quick tag, and this is just for if you're going somewhere, maybe you want to bring a beverage, maybe you want to bring a bottle of wine or sparkling cider. I went ahead and grabbed our Christmas Traditions paper pad, and this is another one, again, you could do multiples of. You could make 10 of these tags, like, in a matter of moments. So I grabbed this circular die, which is called Rings Around the Circle. So cute, isn't it? It's got all the little rings around the edge. I thought it made it really festive. It's not necessarily a Christmas die, but I thought it made it so cute. So here's the die cut. Isn't that fun? It's kind of got a doily look, right? And then I just took one of our essential circles, and you could die cut, again, maybe 10 different circles, 6, whatever you want to do out of any of these delightful patterns. And then I would just grab my little tape runner. And then you just want to adhere your die cut circle. Again, this is essential circles. And it marries up beautifully. And then maybe I'll grab my Barely Arts glue. Let's see here. Put it on the back. Don't want to get too much. There we go. So this is a little glimmer sentiment that I did. I'm going to put it a little bit lower on this tag. And sometimes I like using the, why you use the wet glue here, is you can do your little minor adjustments, you know, as you finish up. So this is a really great glimmer set. This is the mini sentiments, mini Christmas sentiments, and it's got so many. It's got 28 different plates on here of all the different glimmer sentiments, anything you'd ever want to say, basically. This one I thought was perfect, a gift for you. And then I thought, that's it. That's all you need to do. You could, again, grab a length of ribbon or a length of twine, and you just pop this tag, again, on a bottle, on a beverage, on a gift box, you know, anything you need, and super cute. You could even put your sentiment on the back. So fun. I told you guys these are quick, right? So here's a fun panel. I'm actually going to bring my heart to heart tag back. This is a fun panel that I did quite a while ago, just for a demo when I was doing a background. And then of course I had it left over. So again, another tip for you, grab some of your leftover pieces. Maybe you've stenciled them. Maybe you've, you know, layered up some pieces. So I am going to bring my machine back in here. Dig through your scrap pile, and that's where you're going to find some of these little gems like I did that happen to have our little snowy stencil on it. So again, I'm going to cut the tag out. This has got some of our great little glitter on here too. And And now instead of a card background, which I had originally made it for, I've cut into this cute little tag. And again, on top of this, you don't have to put anything. You could tie a ribbon, you would be done. You could put a sentiment. But I did find one more little guy that I had put together again for a different project. And that's our little Chill Bear. How cute is this die? It's just one of my favorites, little minis. And it's kind of a powerhouse too. So you can grab him. I had him already put together, but look how perfect. Put a couple little foam squares. I like to pop him up. You could make it flat too, but move him over a little bit. But how cute is he on the bottom of this tag, right? Just kind of prancing along, and again, take your length of ribbon or whatever you want here, and you have a perfectly adorable gift tag. So cute. Okay, I'm gonna show off one more tag, and this one we did, gosh, quite a while ago, but I am sure I have not showed it to you guys on Tridy Friday yet. So this die set is super cute, and we have a lot of samples online of different projects we've done, but I don't believe this one is. So it's called Through the Woods, and it makes this really cute kind of snow globe look, and of course it has the little truck, which you know we're fond of our little trucks and vehicles here at Spellbinders. But all I did was double cut the background, cut an extra circle, so this not only is, could be an ornament, but also ends up being a gift tag, because see, I just took a piece of extra cardstock, I'll flip it over, put one little score line here, and now it becomes this tag. So you're just gluing an extra piece. All it is one extra circle on the back. And so now you can open it, write your little greeting, or it can double up as an ornament. So that one I thought was super fun. This, I wouldn't put this quite in the quick and easy category because there are a little, few little fiddly pieces that you have to add, but how cute is that? Totally worth the extra effort. So again, that's our Through the Woods die. Here's another card that I wanted to share because I know I haven't shared it yet and time is running short. This also is using the paper from that paper pad. Let me bring it back in real quick from the Christmas traditions. So that's what the background is, even though it kind of looks like gold foil, but it is a foiled paper that's in this paper pad. And then we've just simply decked it out with all these gorgeous Christmas blooms. I know this has been one of our best sellers, so I'm sure a lot of you have it in your stash already. But again, look at those blooms. Just pop them in any color, pinks and reds and teals, and absolutely love this one. Again, you have that lovely sentiment already from the other set I showed earlier. And one last card before I let you go. I'm excited to get kind of in the last minute card finishing mode that I have to do. This is a stamp set called Vintage Holidays, and it's so, so cute. Again, totally vintage. You've got the cute little couple in the car gathering their tree, or the little shopper girl and all these cute little sentiments. And again, because I haven't showed this card already, I thought I would just pop it in and show you. Done some beautiful coloring on the sweet little shopper with all her packages. This is all of us right now, right? It's the most wonderful time of the year. So cute. One of our darling plaid embossing folders in the back. So again, those of us who are stampers, we love to grab our stamps out and, you know, spend a couple extra minutes and make that extra special card. But let me grab a couple of my tags back in here just to kind of line them all up for you. Oh my gosh, so fun. I hope that you all are having a little bit of time still to do some crafting and amongst all your other holiday goodness. And I hope that this hopefully inspired you a little bit on today's Tridy Friday. I hope you all have a great weekend crafting or shopping or getting together with family or all the good things that you do. We definitely are enjoying that here at Spellbinders also. So have a great weekend. We'll see you next week for Tridy Friday. And as always, check out our website at spellbinderspaperarts.com where you'll find all the new things, all the things on sale, and all the things for the great gifts. So have a great weekend. See you soon.